Let's look at drawing all the possible stereoisomers for this particular compound, which has two chiral centers in it. When you approach a problem like this, it's always best to do it as systematically as possible, to have a method that you're going to follow. Now, we know that since this has two stereocenters, it can have at most 2 to the 2 or 4 possible stereoisomers. The way that I like to approach this problem is to draw my stereoisomers in the Sawhaus projection form. And we can start by drawing any one of the 4. I like to start with this one because I've put my smallest groups away from me, which makes it easier and the easiest way to draw it so that I can assign the stereochemistry at my two stereocenters. And without going into a discussion of which group has priority over which, we can look at this molecule and assign the stereocenters as R and S. So that's my first stereoisomer. Now, to draw the second one, what I like to do is draw the mirror image of my first one. So this is my second one, which is the mirror image of my first one. And I want to look at that a little bit more in my three-dimensional models. So this is a three-dimensional model of my first stereoisomer. I've color-coded my groups over here the same way they're colored in my three-dimensional model. And I want to talk about how I go from this one to this one. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull up an exact copy of this molecule. So here is an exact copy of this molecule. Now, it may not look like this is an exact copy the way I've drawn it, but what you'll see is if I take this molecule and rotate it correctly, I just gotta lower that a little bit and then drag it over here. I don't have it quite lined up perfectly. You can see after rotating, they are exactly the same molecule. So going back to my original display of this copy, what I want to talk about is how do I go from this, which is identical, to making this into the mirror image? Well, if we start at this center right here, to make this center the mirror image of this center, I switch the position of these two groups, my hydrogen and my bromine, or actually my hydrogen and my iodine. And now these two, this center is the mirror image of this center. I can do the same thing on the other side. In order to make this center the mirror image of this one, I switch these two groups. And now these two molecules are mirror images of one another, just like over here. The reason I wanted to go through that is because it helps us assign the stereocenters over here. When I switch the position of two groups like I did over here, I switch the stereochemistry. So since this was S, this is R. And likewise, since this one was R, its mirror image is S. So those are my first two stereoisomers. I draw the third one by starting with my first one and just changing the position of any two atoms on one of my stereocenters. So I'm going to switch this position, this atom and this atom, my bromine and my hydrogen. Leave everything else the same. Now, since I switched the position of two groups over here, these two right here, I switched the stereochemistry of that stereocenter. Since I didn't change anything over here, the stereochemistry stays the same. And I have the SS stereoisomer. I can look at that in my three-dimensional models as well. So this molecule is an exact copy of this molecule. And to go from this original to my new stereoisomer, I just switched the position of these two groups. And I have my third stereoisomer, unchanged at this center, changed at this center, from RS to SS. Finally, to draw the last stereoisomer, I just draw the mirror image of this third one. Since this was SS, my new mirror image is RR. And I can do that in the three-dimensional models also. So this is an exact copy of this one. To turn this into this mirror image, I switch these two groups, changing. Then I switch these two groups, changing the stereocenter. And if I want to display this one the way I've drawn it over here, I can just rotate this molecule like this. And now I have it the way it's shown over here. This and this are mirror images. Now that I have my four stereoisomers, I can also talk about enantiomers and diastereomers. I've numbered all four stereoisomers. I've got two pairs of enantiomers, my two sets of mirror images. 1 and 2, and 3 and 4. All other possible combinations are diastereomers. Because a pair of stereoisomers that are not enantiomers are diastereomers.